morning and blessed Pentecost to you, and a joyful celebration of this feast in the coming days. The Easter season concludes today, and next Sunday, Trinity Sunday, we have gone the full cycle of the revelation of Christ, so that you've got a birth, an epiphany, an understanding of who Christ is, which caused us to repent of our sins in Lent. We got the resurrection and understood more about who Christ was, and in the ascension we saw our own lives taken up with his into glory. And now the Holy Spirit comes, the church is emboldened to proclaim the gospel, and on next Sunday we celebrate the complete revelation. God is one in three and three in one, a blessed Trinity. And what that means for each one of us. So as we celebrate this feast of Whitsunday, Pentecost, let it be our care to think through this week toward the full revelation which has been given to us through the church seasons, and what the implications for us and our lives are. That being said, Trinity Sunday also is the beginning, or I should say, it ends the choral season, ends the regular season, and we move then to the long vow. In your leaflet, it says that that starts tomorrow. Well, clearly this is not Trinity Sunday, so there must be something wrong. It's the following Monday, the 23rd, which is the beginning of the long vow. So next Sunday is at 10:30, as usual. Following that, the 29th, we shift to 10 o'clock. The daily offices are suspended from the 23rd until Michaelmas. I know that we have another notice to be made. Would you like to do that?
Yes, thank you. Tomorrow, as the third Monday of the month, we will be making sandwiches for our day of the Feed My Sheep program. To be distributed by the Salvation Army throughout Baltimore. If you can join us, we will meet in the parish house kitchen beginning at 4 o'clock tomorrow on Monday. I would also ask you to consider, if you haven't already, contributing to this program. 100% of the proceeds go towards the food that goes directly to the people who need it, and for around $140 a month, we managed to distribute 300 sandwiches, 150 granola bars, and 150 snacks that go along with them to help feed the people of Baltimore. So if you would consider sponsoring a month or a part of a month, it would be greatly appreciated. And those donations are made to St. John's, just with Feed My Sheep in the subject line. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other notices that need to be made? Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you. Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is
very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee. O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, according to whose true promise, the Holy Ghost came down on this day from heaven, lighting upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth. Uniting peoples of many tongues in the confession of one faith, and giving to thy church the power to serve thee as a royal priesthood, and to preach the gospel to all nations. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Thank you.
to thee, O Lord our God, for that thou didst create heaven and earth, and didst make us in thine own image. And of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made there a full and perfect sacrifice for the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy people do celebrate and make with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again with power and great glory. We most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy word and Holy Spirit, to bless and sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be unto us the body and blood of thy dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, whereby we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies. Grant, we beseech thee, that all who partake of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and also that we and all thy whole church may be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the peace. Alleluia.
The gift of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.